Everybody, it's Invicta. It's time for another Solo Queue Silliness here on the channel as we continue Karazim Week. Today, I'm going to be playing a super fun build, but it's probably terrible. And you know what? That's the name of the game because it's Solo Queue Silliness. On our team today, it's going to be Vala, Karazim, Nazebo, Malfurion, and Kael'thas taking on Reyner, Zagara, Uther, Kael'thas, and Karazim. So, what I'm going to be doing today is I'm going to be apparently lagging, that's good. And secondly, what I'm going to be doing is trying out my Uber Tank build that I've been playing on Karazim lately, and it is a lot of fun. I absolutely mean a lot of fun. What this build does is it makes Karazim into a sort of hybrid warrior, but more along the lines of a tank, more so than a warrior. And it's a lot of fun. He's going to have self-healing from not only the taking Transcendence level 1, but he's also going to have, of course, Breath of Heaven, which is his W ability. And I take nothing but defensive talents. Like I said, this is something that it's a build that I haven't actually tried in live games yet.
I was destroying those bots, though. Yeah, it's pretty impressive, Sinvicta
and Krendor. Anyway, but it's a lot of fun. So it may not be the best spec, and it certainly is not the way, in my opinion, that Karazim should be played. But man, oh man, is it quite hilarious when a lot of teams try to go after you, and it turns out they can't kill you at all. And it's just a lot of fun. I like playing the wonkier out there builds instead of the cookie cutter stuff, just because it opens up new possibilities, and who knows, you might find a final build out of there. You never know, man. You never know. It's going to be Kael'thas and Karazim in the mid here. With Vala back in the mid as well. And I was getting a little bit of healing done. By the way, Transcendence does allow me to heal off of my basic attacks. It also allows me to heal my partners off of my basic attacks as well. It prioritizes the lowest hero that is in range of you. So right there, it got done healing me, so it went over to Vala afterwards. That's very awesome indeed. But the downside is, of course, that Karazim is super duper mana hungry, man. He is crazy mana hungry, which is what we talked about earlier in the earlier game from today. I've been thinking about doing this build, combining it with Insight, which is what I took in the last game earlier this morning. If you've not seen that game, by the way, definitely go check it out. It was a lot of fun. Albeit a little bit of a wonkier game. For level 4, I'm going to take Protective Shield. And this all goes into me just making sure that I'm able to keep myself alive, but still be an asset, still being able to deal a decent amount of damage or healing depending on what you need. Here's the reason why I haven't been trying I have not been trying Insight, easy for me to say, with this build yet. It's because I still like having the ability to be a support. I like being able to heal myself along with my allies. And if I take Insight, the only way that I'm able to heal my allies is by using the Breath of Heaven. And that's neat, but it's not as fun as doing it with basic attacks, man. Woman. Nerd or nerdette out there. So Protective Shield, what that will do is that will give me a 15% of my HP absorption shield every 60 seconds, which is fantastic. Again, making Karazim even that much harder to kill. And yes, I do take Divine Palm in this build. I do not take the Seven-Sided Strike. The combination of myself and Malfurion in this team comp will prove to be interesting. We've got good damage with Kael'thas, good utility, and Vala, of course. Good utility with Nazebo and Karazim, and then, of course, we have the standard healer out of Malfurion. Assuming that he went heals, which looks like he's going pretty standard so far. And again, always what's going to be the downside of Karazim is the simple fact that if you don't have anything to basic attack, you just don't get any, you get no use out of his trait. So it's hard to find a good middle ground of making sure you're A, being able to deal damage, B, making sure you're able to keep yourself alive and your teammates alive, and C, making sure that you're all having fun doing it too as well. And that's obviously going to be the biggest thing. Protective Shield saving me there from Jimmy. I do need to be careful. Jimmy does have an extended range on his basic attack. 8 seconds left on the fountain, and like right now my trait's not doing anything for me, which is unfortunate. But I feel that Karazim is just not an early game, in my opinion anyway. He is not an early game He's not really an early game hero. He's more of a, it scales fairly well later on hero, which is not proper grammar. I don't even care about that. But you know what I mean, though. Like, early game, Karazim does feel pretty darn weak. And I'm not calling for buffs or anything like that. It's just that's just the natural trait of the character. Early game, he does feel a little bit of gimp. He does feel a little bit gimpy, but late game, he definitely gets way powerful, and it is a lot of fun, especially after level 16. Yeah, I've got 5 gems here, and Raynor's actually found himself a little bit out of there. I was able to throw the protective barrier on Bala. So I do need to make sure I don't get a little bit too crazy here. Second wave of Breath of Heaven. I'm trying to see if I can get Uther to charge me here. I wanted him to run into the Web Weaver, but that's okay. I will be heading back down. Right now, very low scoring game. 0-0 after almost six and a half minutes. That's pretty impressive for a quick match. To not have a first blood, showing you the capability of both teams. Whoa, Vala. Whoa there. Little too close for comfort. She was lucky that she wasn't completely blocked by that wall. I don't really care about the auto attack damage from Jimmy right now. I can just either regen it up naturally, or I can just basic attack. So Uther and I are just going to have a smack off here, and it's not going to be too good for Uther. Especially after he just used his Hammer of Justice. He's got to save the Hammer of Justice to stop me from using Deadly Reach. And Uther getting a little bit too cocky, may have overextended. There we go. Got the execution. That is going to be the first blood. Nice job by Vala and Zeebo coming down from the mid. And now I am free just to basic attack myself back up to full. Lotan, like I said, I do take Divine Palm. The more I play with it, the more I like it. I still think for DPS or warrior heavy opponents, you want to be going for seven-sided strike. But for the most part, I do enjoy Divine Palm. It gives you a lot of freedom. It also means that you don't really have to worry about dying a whole lot, which is the name of the game when it comes to this build, this tanky-ish immortal build. I'm not sure what I'm going to call it yet. I probably came up with a clever title for it, though. Or maybe not clever, I don't know, man. I'm not the sharpest knife in the drawer, if you get my meaning. Darth Yogurt, what a name. Yeah, look how much of the damage I was able to get on the entire wave there. Webweaver was able to take down the gate, but not much else. He did lose Kael'thas somewhere. And if I had seven-sided strike, I would definitely be able to take down Jimmy. I did see him call in the Banshees, though, so I'm going to back up. No real reason for me to tap the fountain right now. And I think the Banshees may have flown off already, or he retargeted them on Nazebo. I'm not sure. Yeah, there they are. Apparently this Raynor doesn't know. There you go, Raynor. I was going to say, apparently this Raynor doesn't know how to control the Banshees yet, but he figured it out. So the enemy team only got a gate, I think, for their Web Weavers. Oh, they got a turret and a gate up top. Not a big of a deal. I do have 19 gems now, but it's not safe for me to go in for the turn in quite yet. Let's see what Vala and Kael'thas are doing. Almost got him. Nice Divine Palm by the enemy team's Karazim there. I'm gonna save Kael'thas with Divine Palm, use it for him, not myself. Here comes Malfurion. That's Reaper Malfurion. And unfortunately, we don't have Vala here. We do have Kael'thas back, however. And there's the Tranquility going out on, combined with Breath of Heaven. Man, oh man. You talk about a lot of healing right there. Unfortunately, I am out of ammo. Yeah, I'm out of ammo, guys. Unfortunately, I'm out of mana. And I do not have Divine Shield. By Divine Shield, I mean Divine Palm. But I am going to go back. None of us did die. Very, very close. It's a clutch route by Malfurion for sure. There he goes. Level 13. I'm going to take Spell Shield. Spell Shield, part of my absolute monster uber. We go all defensive build. It's a fun build, man. I'm telling you. If you want to try to solo with this build, it's pretty safe. You don't have to worry about too much. Just don't expect to really light up the DPS charts. I do still have 19 gems that I would like to unload right now. Spell Shield, by the way, will reduce the amount of ability damage by 50% once every 30 seconds. Take down the top fort, and we're making sure they're getting away right now. Kael'thas gotta be a little bit careful. Right now my Spell Shield is broken, but that is okay. Another tense standoff. Very, very close game right now. 4-1, but don't let that fool you. It is very close. Debo's got to be careful here. I'm not going to use Divine Palm unless if I absolutely have to, and right now I don't really feel like I do. I'm prepared to use it, though. There's Tranquility coming down there. Oh, what a nice gravity lapse by Kael'thas! And actually, Zagara screwed up her team. I tried to get Divine Palm on Vala. Turns out she doesn't need it anyway. But man, oh man, Zagara saved our team from the Divine Storm there. And now she's going to go down. And we should get a pretty nice push out of this Webweaver phase here. And look how much Second Echo does heal for... on Vala there, over 500 nearly. That's really, really good. I still have Divine Palm. I still have the Protective Barrier well. By the way, apologies for the lack of commentary of this game. This is a very, very close game right now. Very, very close. Vala doing a decent amount of damage there on Jimmy, and I should be able to get a couple of auto heals off while we were pushing. Spell Shield back up. I'm not sure what the enemy team's Karazim was thinking there. Level 16 is where it really starts getting fun. Level 6 AM, I'm going to be going for Soothing Breeze. Soothing Breeze basically stops all crowd control on me or my target that I'm able to land the Breath of Heaven on. And it's basically an AoE, it's an AoE root break, which is a lot of fun. Well, it should be okay here. We were able to take down another kill there, so yeah, it was a fantastic push. I have experimented with going for Circle of Life. The problem is that normally I don't find myself around that many heroes to get out of it. And I find that it's easier for me just to have the CC break more than anything. Whoa, Uther, where are you going, Uther? Yeah, so I should be able to top off myself and Vala with the... myself, Vala, and Kael'thas with basic attacks, which just happened there. Oh, Uther walked up for the Divine Storm. He did get Divine Palmed, however, by Karzi. It's still not going to be enough. He's going to go down. And Malfurion's using Tranquility right now. There you go, and I don't even have to worry about aiming my auto-attack healing. It just goes on whoever's lowest. So Vala gets taken out by the Maw, but she should be okay. Get the second heal for Kael'thas. There we go. Right now, again, very, very exciting, crazy game. After a slow start, it has been all Team Solo Q, Mid Silliness, 9 LMQ, Copenhagen, Wolves, Toys R Us, Have Your Way, Toasty Quiznos Station. It's 10-1 now. Again, look at that healing, too. This is me in full defense build as well. Still getting a lot of utility out of having the Transcendence passive. I'm going to tap the fountain here just so I can get a little bit more mana, and we should definitely go for the boss. We have 3 levels up. No reason not to, although now the enemy team, never mind, they do know that we were coming up, so. Enemy team, with Zagara being here, they know that we're going to be going for it. And we could try to goad them into a big fight here. We do need to be careful we don't get caught up in the Maw going right into a Divine Storm and Kael'thas combo. Enemy team were able to get the Web Weavers, but Vala's going to go ham on everybody. Going to go after Zagara here. Zagara going to be caught by herself. She is going to get taken out. I am able to get the kill on Jimmy. And I'm just going to keep on pushing, man. Uther's going to get saved by Divine Palm. That's not going to save him for very long. And we are again coming up with a monster push. This is during the enemy team's Web Weaver phase, keep in mind. Yeah, down goes Kael'thas, and can we get the final kill? Oh, I was going for it. It was so close. Are we just going to ignore the Web Weavers? I think we are. And yeah, that's just going to be it. So what a game, man. What a very exciting game. Didn't even get the full build, but here's the build anyway if you want to try it out for yourself. Level 20, by the way. I do take, get out of here. No, score screen, get out of here. Level 20, I do take Storm Shield. Sometimes instead of Storm Shield, I do take the, I forget the other one. The one that restores mana and allows you to Radiant Dash. Anyway, that is going to be it. Thank you for watching, everyone. Very fun game, and I'll see you next time for more Karazim. Until then, so long, everybody!